disease which claimed one life every 8 minutes. One of those lives was Freddie Mercury's, who died at 45 last Sunday.
A one-off, you know. You don't get too many people like him.
You ask Freddie how much a pint of milk is, forget it. He'll be able to tell you the price of nail lacquer.
Well, maybe we should all say a bit.
No, that was fine. Just get on with it. Otherwise, I'll forget my name. And then
one dream, one soul, one prize, one gold, one golden glass. Of what should be.
Freddie Mercury was born Frederick Bolzara on the 5th of September in Zanzibar, Africa. He became lead singer of Queen in 1971, one of the most enduring rock bands of recent times. Their lineup remained unchanged, with Brian May on guitar, John Deacon on bass, and Roger Taylor on drums. Mercury came from a band called Wreckage, and although in Queen's early days endured critical hostility, they managed to plug the gap in the British pre-punk music scene.
I see a little silhouette of a man.
Scaramouche, Scaramouche, will you do the fandango?
Thunderbolt and lightning, very, very frightening me.
In 1975, their album, A Night at the Opera, rumoured to be the most expensive UK production since the Beatles' Sgt. Pepper, spawned the six-minute Bohemian Rhapsody. It became the longest-selling UK hit in 20 years, and its video is regarded as the one which spawned the video age.
It's a survival test, you know. And I mean, of course, we could all just go away and say, okay, we've had enough, and live happily ever after. But I mean, I don't think that's what we're in. We're in it to make music, and the way I think, well, what else could I do? I mean, this is the thing that interests me most. You don't know what it means to, I mean, when you write a song where people actually appreciate and they say it's a good song. It's a wonderful feeling.
Mamma mia, let me go. Beelzebub, and the devil put his back on me. On me.
Had a good voice. That's always been the anchor of that group, I think.
Freddie Mercury is one of life's originals. Drawing from a completely unique collection of sources, he's assembled a lifestyle that resembles few others. So far, there are no signs of Freddie Mercury succumbing to conservatism.
I want to break free.
I've dined to dress up and drag, doesn't everybody? But it's just one of those things. In fact, it wasn't my idea at all. I'm sure everybody thinks it's my idea being outrageous.
It was, wasn't it?
It was. I mean, it came from Roger, and I was. And everybody thinks, I bet. In fact, they asked me, so how did you get the other three to get into it? In fact, they ran into their frocks quicker than anything.
God, no.
I don't really analyze myself to that degree. The way I look at myself, if I ever do, is that I'm a man of extremes. My character on stage is totally different to what I am off stage. And I just think I have a very soft side and a very hard side. You either get me where I'm very strong or I'm very soft. So if the right person gets me, they'll find me that I'm very vulnerable and I can be a real baby. But then sometimes people meet me and they're very hard. When I'm hard, I'm very strong. Nobody can get through to me.
That was almost it. Try another one, okay? Boom. Da-da! More rhythm. How did you want to go? That's what you did on the other tape.
Oh, I
feel
on a different tape.
All right. Hey!
One man, one
tape.
One go.
Yeah.
Over later years, they continued to demonstrate their versatility as a band, with Mercury as a constant charismatic centerpiece. Although they all worked on solo ventures, including Mercury's acclaimed duet with opera singer Montserrat Caballé, the band had an enduring quality. In the 80s, they teamed up with Bowie to record Under Pressure, appeared at Live Aid,
and then when they did do Live Aid, they were absolutely, I think, the best band of the day. You know, whatever your personal taste is irrelevant. When the day came, they played the best, they had the best sound, they used their 17 minutes or whatever to the best. I mean, they understood the idea exactly that it was a global jukebox, as I described it.
Do it all over again? Yes, why not? Why not? I do it slightly differently.
Priests and was attended solely by Freddie's family and friends. Flowers had been sent from all over the world, covering more than a quarter of an acre. The flowers accompanied Freddie in 5 laden hearses. The weekend of the 14th and 15th of December will be dedicated to Queen here.